This cinematic title animation is looking so cool, right? Hi guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions and I will show you how to create this cool looking title animation in DaVinci Resolve. Trust me, this is absolutely easy to create using few simple steps. You can use this animation for your music videos, short films, cinematic blogs and more. So without any further ado, let's go. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 19 and all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on this setting button in the corner. Set the size of this project 1920 by 1080 which is a full HD resolution. But if you want to create this animation in 4K, just select the option Ultra HD from here. Now we need to select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 24 frames per second which is good for cinematic title. Once it's done, just click on Save. We need to import a video clip for this title animation, so just go to media pool. If you don't have this media pool, click on this media pool button, right click on that, click on import media and select a video clip. So this is the video clip. Download the video clip for practice and click on open. You can select any video clip that you like. Here we have two different options, change and don't change. So if you want to change the project setting according to your video clip, you can click on change, otherwise you can click on don't change. So this is the video clip here, just drag and drop on the timeline. I'm gonna use the 7 second and 10 frame of this video clip. So let's make a cut on 7 second and 10 frame. I'm gonna trim this video clip just like this. I'm gonna place this video clip right over here. After that, we need to create shutter animation for this video clip. So what we have to do, just go to effect section, effects, and this is the adjustment clip. Just drag and drop the adjustment clip on the timeline. We need 3 second long adjustment clip. So let's make this 3 second long. Place the adjustment clip right over here. Go to fusion page and here we have to attach a rectangle mask with this media in. So select the media. Click on rectangle, click on single viewer. Here we have the width in the inspector window. Just increase the width value and set it 1. Go to the end of this animation, right click on height, click on animate, set the height value 1. Go to very first frame of this animation, let's set the height value 0. Now just go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen, check the height, click on fit button, select both the keyframes and click on a smooth button here. Now just go to edit page and you can see the effect. Perfect. Now we need to create title animation. So what we have to do, just go to effect, titles, and this is the text plus node. Just drag and drop the text plus right over here. Just place the CTI on 7 second. Drag it like this and make it 7 second long. After that, I'm gonna place this on half a second. So according to 24 frame per second, it should be 12 frame for half second. Placed it over here. Just go to inspector window and here you can type anything, whatever you like. I'm gonna select Gobold font style. So this is the Gobold extra one. I'm gonna increase the size of the text 0.2 and select the color red. And this is the tracking amount. I'm gonna set the value 0.97 or 8. Perfect. And then just go to the fusion page. And here we have to do some adjustment with the text. First of all, we need to set this in center. So just go to preview window, go to guide and turn on this guide. Let's set the text in the center. After that, we need to add one more text. So this is the text node, drag and drop the text over here. I'm gonna attach this text with this template. So what we have to do, this is the merge node. Take a merge node, hold shift on the keyboard, attach this merge just like this. You can see the connection here. It is looking like this. Now we have a green point for the foreground. So connect the green point with this text one. Perfect. Now you can type second text over here. I'm gonna select the font style Bebas New Pro. So this is the Bebas New Pro. Of course, you can select any font style that you like and I'm gonna set it italic style. And this is the tracking. Let's set the tracking amount 0.97, I guess. Once done, click on fit button. After that, we need to animate the second text. So select the text, just go to frame number 100, right click on tracking, click on animate, or you can also click on this diamond button to create a keyframe. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the tracking amount value 1.03. So we will get this type of animation over here. Perfect. Now we need to animate the opacity of this text. So select the text one, just go to setting, just go to frame number 36, which is equal to 1.5 seconds. Right click on opacity, click on animate, just go to frame number 12, which is 0.5 seconds. Let's set the opacity 0 and repeat the same thing at the end of this animation. So just go to frame number maybe 120, right click on opacity, click on set key, and just go to frame number 44 and set the opacity 0, I guess. Once done, just go to spline window. Here we have two different animated keyframes. So just check this character spacing, click on fit button, highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, uncheck this one, check the opacity, click on fit button. Here we have two different keyframes for starting. So hit S to smooth and repeat the same thing for this one. So make this graph something like this. And here we have smooth animation. Now let's make one more animation for whole text. So select the merge one, click on transform and add a transform node right over here. Just go to frame number 120, right click on size, click on animate, just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the scale value 1.15. We will get this type of zoom out animation. Now just go to spline window, hit F4, uncheck all the nodes, check the transform size only, click on fit button, highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth. Now close the spline window and it's done. We have to add one more thing. Just select the text node, hit Ctrl plus a space bar for search box and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect. Hit add button just after this text one, just like this. All right, and then just go to edit page, and here we have text animation. And at the end of this animation, we need to create fade out effect. So just go to 6 seconds and 12 frame and set the opacity point right over here. And here we have fade out effect, and do the same thing for this one. So just go to 2 seconds back in time, 7 seconds and 10 frame. Place the opacity point right over here. And finally, let's add cinematic sound effect. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and I'm going to use this cinematic sound that I have downloaded from freetouse.com. I will give you a link in the description. Just open it up, drag and drop this audio clip right over here. You can increase the size, and you can see here, here we have bass drop effect. So I'm going to place this bass drop just starting off this text. So if you play the animation, it will look like this. Perfect. Now I'm going to add a cut at the end. I'm going to add a fade out effect just like this. And now it's done. So let's have a look. Just turn on the loop button. Go to very first frame of this animation. Hit Ctrl F to full screen and let's have a look. And finally, this is looking amazing, right? So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. For more such videos, subscribe to this channel, like this video, and also comment below what you think about it. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.